Good morning, everyone. We find ourselves today Erev Shabbos Kodesh, almost Erev Shavuos as well, and we are continuing in our learning of Emuna and Hashgacha Pratis, how to recognize and see HaKadosh Baruch Hu in every aspect of our lives. And Rav Volbe pointed out yesterday that the mode of tefillah, of our prayers, is a tremendous opportunity that HaKadosh Baruch Hu gives us three times a day to utilize the time to recognize Hashem, to see that everything ultimately is coming from Him, and in that way we enhance our connection with the Ribbono Shel Olam, the Master of the Universe, who is running our lives to the smallest detail all of the time. And he writes, Chazal Omrim, the sages tell us, Shela Adam Yesh Mazala, a person has mazel. They have a mazel. What does a mazel mean? Shedarchehu nishma mikol hezek. There is a certain mazel. We have to define what that means exactly. That helps to guard a person so that they shouldn't find themselves in danger. It guards them from dangerous situations. Haloshon mazel ba miloshon noizel. Says Rav Volbe that the word mazel, which we would normally translate in English as luck, something as auspicious, something good favor for a person, it comes from the word nozel. Nozel means a flow. And if a person in Hebrew has a runny nose, it's called a nozelet. Their nose is running, it's flowing. If a faucet is running, it's the berez is nozel, the berez is running. The mazel of a person is something that is flowing and that is running here into this world. And that means that it's coming from above and it's flowing down into our lives. Me'eifo hu noizel, from where is this mazel, from where is this positive energy in the person's life, where is it flowing from? Ein lanu tefisa be'inyan, we don't really understand exactly where it's coming from. But we understand clearly that obviously it's coming from above. If there's going to be mazel in a person's life, they're going to have siyata d'shamayim, they're going to have heavenly assistance, they're going to see goodness and blessings come to them, they understand that there is mazel that is watching over them, obviously it's coming from above, it's coming from the Ribbono Shel Olam. This mazel that a person has, it helps for the person to be someone that is protected. It opens up my eyes. It's a light that's coming from this Or HaMakif, which we defined previously as HaKadosh Baruch Hu's presence and essence that's coming in from even outside the physical world. It's above and beyond. And therefore, it has the ability, this mazel, which is noizel, which is flowing into this world from above, it gives the person a clearer insight and understanding of what is going on. Aval behema ein mazala, but an animal doesn't have mazel. B'mnei she'ein lo keshima or hamakif, because an animal doesn't have a real inner connection with the or hamakif, with the light of the Shechina, ulefikach einoy mesaya b'shmirasa. Therefore, there's no mazel to help an animal in its guarding and protecting of itself. But a human being is not like that, and certainly a Jew is not like that. We live a life where mazel is flowing into our lives constantly. And this perhaps is a beautiful idea for us to think about on Erev Shabbos, which is going to turn into Shavuos as well. The greatest flow of divine influence that Klal Yisrael ever experienced was when they stood by Maimed Har Sinai, by the mountain of Sinai, when the Torah was given to the Jewish people. HaKadosh Baruch Hu took His ultimate mind piece, which is the Torah, which is totally removed from this physical world. It was up in Shemayim, in the heavens. Only the Malachim, the angels, knew really the greatness and the grandeur of the Torah. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu took it, and he sent it down into this world, that we, Klal Yisrael, should be zeicha, we should merit to be the guardians of the Torah. Ein mazel gadol mizeh. There's no greater mazel, no greater gift, no greater divine flow of influence that comes from above than the fact that the most spiritual piece in the entire creation, which is the Torah, came down into the hands of mankind, to Klal Yisrael, to guide us and to lead us through this lifetime. And we should know how to live and what to do with every single moment of our lives. And that's the B'siyata D'Shamayah, that's the bracha that HaKadosh Baruch Hu gives us. We have so much to rejoice about this Shavuos, when we recognize and we realize how good the blessings of Torah are in our lives, that we have a purpose, we have a tafkid, we have a goal that we'd like to achieve and reach, and it can only be done through the Torah, and that HaKadosh Baruch Hu bequeathed to Klal Yisrael, unlike to any other nation in the world. May we be zeiche im yetzah Hashem, that these three beautiful days of Yom Tov that are coming upon us, she each day builds up in the momentum, in the enthusiasm, in the connection that we make with the Torah, and ultimately the connection that we make with the Ribbono Shel'olam, when we will be removed from the chaos of the world for 3 days straight, that will give us a deeper opportunity to create everlasting bonds of emunah in our recognition of Hashem, in how we see the gifts of Torah that He gives us, how we feel the divine nozel, the divine mazel that is coming down from above, enhancing our lives, and in that way we can emerge from 3 days of Yom Tov as the happiest nation in the entire world, that we have the Torah and we have our Ribbono Shel'olam. Wishing all of you a good Shabbos, a good Yom Tov, and you should be zeiche to an emissa Kabbalah Satorah, a true receiving of the Torah on this beautiful Yom Tov of Shavuos. All the best.